Today's video consists of multiple keyboard shortcuts for advanced workflow in Adobe Illustrator. So follow along so you can elevate your knowledge with keyboard shortcuts. And sponsoring today's video is Skillshare. Now Skillshare offers thousands of inspiring classes for creative and curious people on topics including illustration, design, photography, video, freelancing, and much, much more. Now, to become a member of this learning community with 2 months of totally free access, stay tuned until the very end of the video and make 2020 the year where you explore new skills and expand on your passions. So the first shortcut is kind of split into two separate shortcuts. Now in the layers window, we can select individual objects on a layer, and the blue icon lets us know when it's selected. But to select them all, simply just hold down the Alt Option key and then click the layers panel here. Now this is a quick way to highlight all objects on a single layer. But also you can press Command or Control A to select everything outside of the layers window. You essentially do the same thing, but without the layers window open. Now the second shortcut is a real gem, and it saves me a lot of hassle in my workflow. Sometimes we have a really busy artboard and we might need to access shapes or objects below other objects very quickly. Now obviously the circle is in the way of the fox below, but I can hold down the Command or the Control key whilst using the selection tool and then just double click. This will grant access to parts of my design below the circle without having to hide or remove other objects. So the third keyboard shortcut helps in viewing your design without any anchor points or handles obstructing your view. They can be annoying sometimes, and so to hide them, simply press Command or Control key and then H. This will hide your anchor points and your handles. Now pressing the same shortcut is going to bring them back into view. Now this is especially useful for those of you who use Illustrator CC and opt to use the anchor points with a large setting. Now one of my favorite tools that I use on a regular basis in my workflow is the group selection tool. Now it doesn't actually have any keyboard shortcut given to it. As you can see, it's right here below the direct selection tool. Now you could always assign your own shortcut, or you can simply use a direct selection tool and then hold down the Alt Option key. And this is going to bring up the group selection tool for use. Now letting go of the Alt Option key will bring you back to the direct selection tool. And so you can easily toggle between the two this way. Now we all know that under the color palette we have the fill box, the gradient box, and then the nothing box. Well, there are actually shortcuts for all three of these. So firstly, if you press the comma key on your keyboard, you will opt to use the fill on a selection, and then you can press a period or a full stop, which will add a gradient, and then a forward slash is going to apply nothing on the object at all. But now a quick example of how to use this and speed up your workflow is that let me just select one part of the fox and then use the select same function to access all orange shapes. I can then press the period key on my keyboard to apply a gradient to all the objects and then press G for the gradient tool so it's applied evenly across the design itself. These three shortcuts are very useful indeed, and when working with color, it just speeds things up a little bit. Now here's a quick and a neat little shortcut for when you're using the Shape Builder tool. Now of course, you need to select your objects as you usually would, and then locate the Shape Builder tool here, or use the shortcut of Shift and M. Now to unite my entire selection, I would have to draw all over the place like so, or I could just hold down the Shift key and then click and drag to select and unite my entire set of shapes. Now this obviously works like the Pathfinder Unite function, but it's nice to know that you have this when using the Shape Builder tool on large designs. Now for the next keyboard shortcuts, I will bring up the preference settings with Command or Control K. Now notice here you have the increment settings, and mine are set to 1. This indicates how far I can nudge an object along my artboard in Adobe Illustrator. So if I press the arrow keys on my keyboard, the fox is going to move along at this pace. However, if I want to speed things up, I can just hold down the Shift key and then nudge them again. So now things are sped up by a factor of 10. And again, this is something that will save you time over your days and your years working with Illustrator. Now this keyboard shortcut is handy if you're working on various documents or have many windows open. Instead of coming up to the top and then selecting the document you want to use, you can just hold down the Command or the Control key and then press the apostrophe on your keyboard to toggle between your documents. Now as I mentioned at the start of the video, sponsoring today's tutorial is Skillshare. Skillshare is an awesome community with an abundance of classes for curious and creative people alike. Most classes are under 60 minutes with short lessons to fit any schedule. This means that they can be easily integrated into your workflow day to day. Now as you guys know, I really like to design posters in my free time, as it's a passion I've come to really enjoy. And so one class I've been eyeing up on Skillshare is a digital poster design class taught by Temi Coker. Now you can join Skillshare and become a member for 2 months totally for free, simply by clicking the link in the description box below. You're going to be able to really grow in the creative areas that you want to for 2020, and you will learn new skills that you've always wanted to master. So do check out Skillshare, link down below. So let me know if you can add some new shortcuts to your workflow arsenal, and do remember, if you want to keep learning essential skills within Illustrator, or as a designer in general, subscribe to my channel for weekly graphic design content. Do have a great day and a positive start to the week, and until next time guys, design your future today. Peace.